backlash because I'm not as bangable as the previous host. It's somehow...
Talk to him, Frost!
Women do not exist to be nice on the eyes for you. Morgan Webb, Olivia Munn did not exist to be nice on the eyes for you. And that's just obvious sexism. You don't need to explicitly objectify women or declare that you hate women to be sexist.
Dude, where is Snake Plissken to set off the EMP when you need him? Just press the button. We've had a good run. Just send us back to the Dark Ages.
You push that button. Everything we've accomplished for the past 500 years will be finished. Our technology, our way of life, our entire history. We'll have to start all over again. For God's sakes, don't do it, Snake!
My name's Plissken.
Hey, dudes and dudettes, I'm Derek with Gamesomniac, and welcome to the fall of G4. Now, do I think G4 is actually dead in the water? No. Obviously, that won't happen until either nobody is watching the shows, or their views get low enough that it's not financially beneficial for them to continue. Regardless, G4 has been on a steady decline since Frosk decided to turn a video game discussion into her own political soapbox, which to me is the biggest fuck you anybody can give. If you've been watching this channel for a hot minute, you'll know I do not like Chris Darryl's Remothered games, because ultimately Chris pulled the same shenanigans. You see, Chris Darryl was working on a remake of Clock Tower the First Fear called Remothered. And it was amazing. The remake went through so many different variations and updates, and ultimately the end design was incredible. Now, according to Chris's team, the remake got hit with some legal authority, which caused them to cease any and all development on the unofficial remake, which, you know, cool, sounds good, makes sense. The only problem is, Chris never updated anybody who was following the project. He just continued to develop the project under the guise that it was still a Clock Tower remake until it was just something brand new and totally foreign to Clock Tower. So all of the fans who supported the remake did so because of the Clock Tower connection, which no longer existed. Given the fact he didn't notify people of what was going on and what kind of game they were going to get in the end, it's my personal opinion that he led everybody on. And Frosk has done the same exact thing. Fans believed they were watching a video game discussion, tuned into that video specifically for that purpose, only to be met with a political attack against them. It's a fucking shame that all of the stupid people are given the opportunity to be seen and heard in front of the masses. The fact that you would take advantage of that position of power is fucking disgraceful. People have the right to decide for themselves if they want to tune into your fucking hate speech TED talk. You don't falsely advertise one thing to lure them in and then ambush them with your self-esteem issues. If there is an important social and political issue that needs to be addressed, do so in its own video. And I'm not even saying that the whole sexism in gaming thing isn't an issue. But what you look like compared to Olivia Munn and Morgan Webb, and how your viewers perceive you in terms of attractiveness, is neither sexism nor is it a fucking issue. It's literally just personal preference and how insecure you are with yourself that you felt the need to bring this up on live TV when you should have been talking about video games. You see, to me, sexism in gaming is like when an employee within the industry, male or female, and I know that's against the rules to cite both genders as potential victims, but equality's a bitch and so am I, loses out on some kind of opportunity because of their gender. Now see, to me, that is an issue of sexism in gaming and one worth standing up against. I don't care about how bangable you are. I'm here to listen to some video game discussions. I don't need the only abortion that ever lived, Adam Sessler, talking about how insecure Republicans make him feel. And I don't need the MGK and Ellen DeGeneres love child talking about how men are bad when she does everything in her power to look like one. I need video games. Know your role. It is your job to talk about video games and actually know what the fuck you're talking about. It's amazing to me that anybody outside of nostalgia would even want to watch this corporate manufactured mess when so many independent content creators on YouTube have optimized G4's formula and are far superior in execution. Just remember, kids, the empty can rattles the most. G4 is looking more like a circus than any kind of tech or gaming entertainment, so head on over to YouTube and support your local content creators. And on that note, I'm Derek with Gamesomniac, and for all of your video game entertainment news and more, keep it locked right here at Gamesomniac. Bye-bye!